The Romanov dynasty was the second to rule Russia. They reigned from 1613 until 1917 due to the renunciation of Tsar Nicholas II. The end of the dynasty was defined by the poor ruling of the Tsar and his inability to listen to the Russian people. These factors and more led to the Romanovs' downfall and consequently their assassination. Tsar Nicholas began his reign in 1894, ascending the throne due to being a direct descendant of Catherine the Great. However, he was inept and too inexperienced to rule.
To all of Russia, this was especially noticeable. He married Princess Alix of Hesse, the granddaughter of Queen Victoria of England. They were distantly related. Princess Alix was renamed Alexandra Feodorovna after joining the Russian Orthodox faith.
Together, they started the Romanov family, which included four daughters and one son.
The Romanov family, despite the negative publicity, were known to be kind and polite. The Romanov children were especially friendly. They all lived a simple life, eating a porridge breakfast and sleeping on hard cots unless they were sick. All servants were ordered to call them by their original names, and not their imperial titles such as Duchess or Tsarevich. The oldest child, Olga, was known for her temper, blunt honesty, and compassion. The second oldest child, Tatiana, was better known throughout the public than her siblings. She was practical and had a natural talent for leadership.
The third daughter of the Tsar was Maria, a woman known to be flirtatious to many young men. Her sisters would refer to her as the stepsister because she was so good and never got into trouble. The last daughter of the Tsar was named Anastasia. According to her tutors, she was a gifted actress whose witty remarks could sting. She was most notable for her incredible charm.
The last child of the Romanov family was Alexei, who was the only son of Tsar Nicholas. He was adored by his parents and his sisters, essentially being the baby of the family. He was the most fragile of the Romanov children.
Noticeably, the Romanov family was filled with interesting people. Despite having some bad publicity, they were still loved by some of their subjects. But the question remains, if they were loved, why did they get assassinated? Could there have been something done to prevent all of this bloodshed? What decisions and events led to their loss of power and ultimately their deaths? There were multiple different factors that led to the Romanovs' loss of power. The first of many involved Alexei, who was diagnosed with hemophilia, a condition where abnormal blood clotting can cause a simple, minor injury to become fatal. His diagnosis became a closely guarded secret, as the Tsar didn't want his subjects to know that their son was fragile and vulnerable. Otherwise, the throne would go to the Tsar's younger brother after his death, according to semi-Salic law. Their isolation was misinterpreted by Russia's aristocratic upper class and fostered a climate of suspicion and flagrant resentment.
The next big factor was the Romanovs' close relationship with Rasputin. He was a self-proclaimed holy man from the peasantry ranks who apparently had the magical ability to treat the medical condition of Alexei. The people of Russia did not trust him due to the numerous scandals filed against him, such as rape and sleeping around with multiple women. Many people also believed that Rasputin and the Tsarina were having an affair.
Because of his influence on the Tsarina, who sincerely believed him to be a holy man, as well as the Tsar, who always obeyed his wife out of love, he was often feared to be the real head of the government. In fact, many of the appointments of unqualified government positions made by the Tsarina were done while Rasputin was in the palace. He was later killed by distant members of the Romanov family in late 1916, but by then his influence was too great.
The next factor that led to their downfall was the Tsar's decision to involve Russia in a multitude of wars. The first war that caused resentment among the Russian people was the Russo-Japanese War. Nicholas had wanted to fight for the territory of Korea, while the Russian people didn't desire a war. When the Russians lost, multiple protests began. He tried to quell these protests with the creation of a Duma similar to the British Parliament that would limit some of his powers. However, it didn't last for long and he went back to being an autocratic ruler with a puppet Duma. The reforms that he promised also remained unfulfilled. He also decided to rule Russia in World War I because Russia was in an alliance with Great Britain and France. Many people warned against it, but the Tsar heeded no one and enrolled his people. Russia lost many battles, especially after the Tsar took over the armies in 1915 without much skill or knowledge to aid them. Russia lost around 7 million people in World War I. Despite these alarming rates, the Tsar refused to back down. Prices surged due to the lack of resources and everyday life became difficult.
These conditions in Russia led to many protests happening throughout the country, the most notable protest being a large strike at St. Petersburg. However, Tsar Nicholas chose to be completely oblivious to what was going on. These protests were defined as the February Revolution. It led to the people opening fire and 2,000 to 4,000 casualties. The Russian army was tired of fighting and joined the protests. Nicholas II abdicated his throne to his younger brother Michael because of Alexei's condition. Michael also abdicated to the provisional government, which led to the collapse of the imperial government. After his abdication, the Romanov family was placed under house arrest at the Alexander Palace, moving from place to place until they finally arrived at Yekaterinburg.
On the 29th of June, 1918, the Ural Regional Soviet Committee agreed to execute the Romanov family, along with their servants. On July 17, 1989, the Romanov family and their servants were ordered to go down into the basement of the floor of the house on the pretext of being relocated to a safer place. While waiting in the basement, the Romanov family was eventually met with an execution squad of secret police. Yurovsky, a leader of the Ural Regional Soviet Committee, read aloud the order of execution given to him by the committee. The execution lasted about 20 minutes and around 70 bullets were fired to kill 11 people.
The Romanovs were dismembered and buried, and their graves were covered up by the perpetrators. However, Alexei and Anastasia were burned 50 feet away from their parents' gravesites. When the main gravesite of the family was discovered and identified, many people believed that the two siblings had survived the night of the killings because they were not among the bodies. The rumors were spurred even further by the popular Anastasia imposter, Anna Anderson, who claimed she was the daughter of the Tsar and was obligated to the Duchess's inheritance. Despite having a history of mental illness, Anna Anderson was believed by many people to be Anastasia. This was all disproved with DNA evidence after her death. Regardless, while the Romanov family is an intriguing topic to read about today, many people wonder how they actually affected Russia and the rest of the world.
The Tsar, Nicholas II, unintentionally brought along the Russian Revolution due to the unpopular choices he had made. This also brought along the collapse of the imperial government, ultimately paving the road for the Soviet Union to come to existence. The rumors surrounding Anastasia's death also left an impact on modern culture. Several movies and plays have been made about her. Overall, the Romanov family execution was seen as a tragic event in the eyes of the Russian people, who believed that the children were treated unfairly. It's a reason as to why Russia today does not acknowledge or celebrate the revolutions.
The Romanov dynasty was the second to rule Russia. They reigned from 1613 until 1917 due to the renunciation of Tsar Nicholas II. The end of the dynasty was defined by the poor ruling of the Tsar and his inability to listen to the Russian people.